testing. Hello. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 1, 2, check, check. Thank you.
Yeah, welcome to the Founders Hall. We are watching some BUCS basketball here for you. My name's George and I'm joined by
Hannah from the women's first team.
It was a good game earlier. You guys nearly brought it back.
It was a tough loss, but we'll get them next time when we play them back in Plymouth.
Yeah, well, exciting prospects on our hands. The men's also playing against Plymouth MARJON. The men's twos, though. Have you got any predictions for the game?
I can't lie. Plymouth do have a strong men's team. They were strong last year. They'll probably be strong this year. So we'll see how it goes, but I'm sure our boys will bring whatever they've got.
They look confident before the game as well on the bench. They were certainly getting very active in your game, sort of jeering and...
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. It helps drive the game forward when we've got a good crowd. So if anybody wants to come on down and support, we'd really appreciate it. And another drive from Plymouth. Out. Oh, and that is a miss from Plymouth there.
The clock shot resets though, so Plymouth got another chance.
And they get it in.
Still that bar free. They've still sort of maintained the lead, but
yeah,
very, very early
absolutely.
On.
Absolutely. 1 point lead, we'll take it. And unfortunately, that was a missed pass. Let's hope the boys get their focus back from early on.
Lovely pass there, and Plymouth go for it, but can't quite get there.
So that's Plymouth passing the ball in.
So good, you can see we've got a slightly obstructed view here in the
Yeah, I've got a perfect view, to be fair.
It's all right, I can see to my left, so
yeah.
I'm going to have to rely on you on the right.
I'll sort the right out, don't worry, George.
But yeah, an explosive start to the game as well. Do you think this is going to be a high-scoring one?
I think so. The men's game is usually more high-scoring than the women's.
There were a lot of jump balls in that women's game as well.
Yes,
so
yeah.
That was sort of what my co-commentators were saying. It'll be interesting to see how Bath play this one.
Yes, it will.
Plymouth here.
That was a foul there, I believe, by 15. Come on, Tim. And Plymouth missed their first free throw.
Have another chance here to get one. Plymouth adding another person.
Yeah, setting up there.
How important is that strategy when a free throw has been taken?
It's usually standard. So what the team will do is they'll have a little team talk during the first one and then they'll go in into position into the second one. Because you can only move and grab the ball after the second one. So that's a back ball, bringing it up there. Nice and steady.
Bath looking for options.
Plymouth maintaining a man-on-man defence. And go for the three, and it's in!
Another three there. MARJON quick to press though.
Yeah. And
don't quite manage to get the shot off, but do draw.
Yeah, another foul from Tim. That's two.
Unfortunate for the man that was in the commentary box. He'll be disappointed with that.
Yeah, he will.
But nevertheless, like we said, a good start. Good start for Bath. The first two free throws were missed. Let's see if number three can get either of those in.
And he makes the first one. It's a shame that it's hard to mark a layup like that when they're pushing into you. There's not really much you can do there. And he makes the second. All right, got number seven bringing the ball up.
Number 11 for Plymouth, very physical there.
And number 15 lost the ball, unfortunately.
We were speaking a little bit during the women's game about sort of height matchups and sort of physicality.
Yeah.
You know, how important do you think those sort of differences can be?
It's really important, unfortunately. Like most sports, the taller you are, the better it is.
Two there.
You've got to be tall when you play basketball. We've always tended to have quite a good team. The men's team, in particular the twos, are very tall this year, however, which is really nice to see. And that's a foul by number 13 for Plymouth. Number three, even, I apologise.
No worries. It is 6-6 here in the Founders Hall, the tied game at the moment, but a chance for Bath here to maybe get something.
That's 16.
Seven on the edge of the area. Passes it to Tim. Tim using his height to find an option. Instead, drives in, goes for the shot.
And that was a lovely and one from Tim. He draws the foul and makes the shot. So now he'll be shooting from the paint.
Redeeming himself from the two fouls.
Yeah, he absolutely is. Absolutely is. So if Tim misses this, the team have 4 seconds to put up another shot. So let's see if he makes it.
We see the different players are there. They're pre-free throw routine. Do you think those are more important than maybe?
a shot from Bath, by the way. It's now currently 10-6.
So it's a high scoring game already.
Yeah.
Only 3 minutes into the first quarter.
Absolutely.
At this rate, we're going to be expecting a very, very fast paced game.
Absolutely.
And how do you think the Bath boys, do you think their stamina's all right? Will they be able to last the distance?
Yeah, I think so. We've got a good bench as well, the twos. They've got a lot of depth, so if they do need to come off, then we've got...
Marjon push forward with a drive straight through the middle. Can't quite finish it off, though, number three. Visibly frustrated there. Marjon maybe have struggled to get into a room.
Yeah, they have. I think, as I said before, I think our height is quite good on this team. We're certainly maintaining it, so I think they're struggling to get in. That's the sub there. We've got number 30, who's Jimmy. Very, very tall chap if you can't see what's going on. So another tall one coming in to see if they can block some of the shots. All right, three is taking a 3-3. And he misses. So here, 3 for Plymouth. We'll take a second.
Here he goes.
And he makes that one.
Just about gets that one. You mentioned Jimmy just come on. He's a first year. The other two were saying earlier that there's been a bit of change in the team this year.
Yeah. So we only had two seniors stay on, which is really uncommon. Usually we have quite a few who stay, but.
Well, trying to get a shot in there. Doesn't quite pull it off.
Plymouth will take that from the sideline. Yeah, so this is a really brand new team, which is impressive to see them come together so quickly. We're only a month really into training, so it's crazy to see them pick it up so quickly.
Exciting matchup between 1 and 7 on the edge of the D. But Plymouth switch it, goes to the 3 and sinks it, does number 11.
So that's 10-10 currently.
Tim moves it up the bar. Number 30 goes to shoot, doesn't want to put it off.
And he gets stolen by number 3, who drives up and takes it out from the other end.
Number 3 has been quite an aggressive player, quite an impact player for Plymouth so far.
Absolutely. I think quite a lot more basketball is aggressive. And he's still got another steal, number 3, really key player for them. Incredible pass, yeah. And in with 11, so easy 4 points on the board for Plymouth.
Just like that, they've extended the lead. And perhaps showing their class against the Bath 2s here. Nevertheless, the Bath will dig in, go for a 3 there. Just missed it.
Yeah, 11 taking the ball back up.
But you know, as we saw in the women's game, these sort of, you know, margins can seem big but can fall quite quickly.
Absolutely. It's got to remain determined.
Plymouth go for a 2 from mid shot. Managed to get it.
Now with a 6-point lead.
Bath will be wanting to get on the board, change momentum, but that Plymouth steal is not going to help. Number 3 doesn't quite manage it.
No. And M20 takes 3 and misses it. But Plymouth regain the rebound and go up again. And miss again, but Bath rebounds.
Lots of 3s being a bit trigger happy from both
teams. Yeah, definitely.
And here comes Tim slowing down the game in the middle.
And a 3 from Jimmy, and he misses that, unfortunately. And it goes out, so that'll be a Plymouth ball.
Number 6 almost flying off the court there.
Yeah, flying into the net.
Good to see the tenacity of the Bath boys, though.
Absolutely.
It looks like a timeout has been called by...
By, I think, the Bath bench.
It's a bit hard to see from our position, but we're going to assume it's the Bath bench.
Yeah, I think we're going to assume
what do you reckon the coach will be telling the players?
I think... He'll be telling them to keep it up, you know, keep the defence strong. We're certainly missing, you know, we're not getting there for the Plymouth guys are taking open shots essentially. So we need to get there and make sure we keep back on defence.
Well, if you're just tuning in or if you're watching on CampusTV, it's 5 minutes play in this first quarter, Bath 10, Marjon 16. Earlier we were watching, you were playing in the Bath women's game. Can you tell us a little insight into that game?
Yeah, it was a tough game, Plymouth. Have always been good. They've got a good squad, and we haven't played them in a long time. So they're quite a tricky team to play. I wouldn't say ruthless, but they.
We saw a lot of physicality.
They're very physical. That's exactly what I'm looking for. But yeah, we brought our A game in the end, but unfortunately didn't quite make it.
And do you think that physicality is translated into the style of play of the men's side?
Yeah, I would say so. I feel like clubs tend to have a general feel to how they play, and that certainly shows in this game. Number 3 has been quite quite physical, but it's working out for him. He's not making any fouls. Too many fouls at least.
A chip on his shoulder. He's been, been an impact player so far as the boys come out. 5 minutes to play here in the Founders Hall. 10-16.
Speaking of three, he will take it from the sideline. And that's one for Plymouth bringing it up.
Tries to find room on the right, cuts into the middle. Number 11, will drive forward.
Take a two, and we'll miss that. And that's a backball.
Number 30 for Bath, we mentioned him earlier. He managed to get up there and knock it away with good ease.
Yeah, I think it should have come off the Plymouth team, which is why it's a backball. But he certainly knocked it out of his hands. And a great pass too. Unfortunately, that didn't quite work out. Plymouth out of bounds there when knocking it out, so that'll be a back ball from the end line in our offensive side.
Here we go. And I think how the Bath boys got on so far this year, what's their record like?
So this is the twos. They did lose against our ones last week, which is as expected. But they're playing well. They've won a couple and lost a couple.
They'll go for a free here.
And that's still in play.
Free manages to get the steal. He's got 11 with him. Try and go all the way himself and misses out.
And that's a foul by six. Grabbing him by the arm. Surprised it's not in the sportsman, like, actually.
And how important as well is, you know, talking about unsportsmanlike conduct, will we see, you know, the Marjon players and the Bar players trying to get inside each other's heads? Maybe a bit of...
The Marjon players were certainly rowdy on the bench when we were playing them. The boys were chatting a lot, and that's a made free throw there by number three. So I can imagine that they'll be loud on their bench, but we haven't seen it yet.
No, and hopefully Bath will be able to get up and make some noise as Free manages to get his second free throw as well.
Yeah,
Tim
really
plays it out for Bath. Marjon managed to knock it out.
Yeah, hopefully the crowds will...
We'll liven up
cheering soon. Yeah. I think everyone's a bit tired after the previous game. It definitely got a bit loud towards the end.
Yeah, massively. But that's it. And it's as we saw in the last game, it was all still to play for in the dying moments.
Absolutely. So that's the two captain coming on there. Let's see if he can make some threes. That's what he's going for. Oh, that's
off.
A lovely drive. And a foul there by number three on Bath 30. So he'll be taking free throws.
And what are the Bath team like at free throws? We were discussing that and how different players can potentially struggle sometimes.
Yeah, the twos free throws aren't the best. But we'll see what they bring today. Let's hope they prove me wrong.
Well, here's number 30 with his first.
And he makes
it.
That's a good start.
Commentator's curse. There we go.
And he goes in for a second.
This to reduce the deficit to six to Marjon.
And he makes it! I'll keep telling them they can't shoot, Cello.
Yeah, exactly. Bath reset here.
Yeah, so that's Plymouth taking it in from the Bath end line. They seem a lot more chilled out, Bath, now.
Yeah, they do. They settle into the game after Marjon went on a bit of a run.
Bit of a run,
to say
yeah,
the least.
Absolutely. They seem to have calmed them down as well and got ahead of them, which is nice to see.
Yeah, definitely. We can't see the coach from our position, but do you reckon he's quite active on the sideline?
I reckon so.
As a player, do you prefer that? Do you often prefer the coach to be more involved, or do you like to just get on with it?
Do you know, it's tricky because you like a bit of both depending on what's going on, depending on the circumstance. So it's a tricky one to say.
Yeah. Well, there's a stoppage in play here.
Yeah, I think there was an issue with the shot clock there. We're back up to 24 now.
Plymouth are underway. 11. Pushing forward.
That's good defence there. He can't have the handoff. That's three taking that. And goes for a pass out. And that's a three and miss three. But Plymouth get the rebound. Number 10 going up. Oh, that was a tough make, to be fair.
Number 10 using his physicality there. Dance around some of the Bath defense.
Yeah, that was tough. Oh, and Plymouth get the steal, and they're back up with a miss.
Number three blocked.
With a dunk attempt. But a miss there. Good passing there from Beth. Oh, unfortunately, that was another steal there.
Back to number three. Will he try another dunk? Yes, he does.
And he misses that,
but
Plymouth get the rebound. got a really good teamwork there. They're dancing around each other. They're setting each other up with screens.
They look confident, to say the least, and they look like they're having a lot of fun.
Yeah, absolutely.
Bath did go ahead at the start of the game, and it's now 20-12 to Marjon, with 3 minutes left on the clock in this first quarter. But Marjon, they look comfortable. They didn't look phased when Bath went ahead.
Yeah, they do. They do definitely look comfortable.
That being said, the Bath boys are, you know, hanging on here. It's only an 8-point deficit.
Absolutely, absolutely. And if they can keep that up, then that's, you know, as we saw earlier, it's easily taken back.
And especially in the first quarter, as we see some changes here, 6 off for 24.
Yep. So that's Yoyar coming on. He's a big player for the Bath side. I think he's not injured at the moment, but I think he's not
he's
on his top
form. He's got strapping on his leg, it looks like.
We've got 27 coming as well, bit of a shooter there for the team. And 30 going in, and unfortunately a miss there.
A steal for Bath.
Steal for Bath, and they're back up. And that's a steal for Plymouth there.
An instant impact for number 24 there, but here comes Plymouth number 10. He goes for the shot, and then manages to sink it. The Plymouth bench starting to get a little bit more active now.
Yeah, the women's team are giving it a little bit loud on the bench now, which is nice to see, even from the opposition.
There goes Bath with another three.
And this is it there. Fortunately, an air ball too.
How bad is that feeling when you get an air ball?
Oh, it sucks. I won't lie.
Yeah.
Oh, nice block from number 15 there. And a travel by number one.
It's good from Tim, who was in the co-commentary earlier, we did mention.
Yeah.
Happy with that. Promising we'd get as many shout-outs for him as possible.
he's certainly getting them. That's a bad pass there. Oh, and a lovely steal by 24. And he'll go in for a drive. And that's put back up by Tim. Really contributing on the court there today.
Yeah, he'll be loving it, he'll be loving it. Inspired by his commentary, sort of that tactical mind he had to get into.
Absolutely.
Plymouth looking for space.
Nice drives and kicks by Plymouth there. That seems to be working for them. Let's hope the Bath coach is Justin
just
is making them aware.
Just under 2 minutes here, Plymouth. Extend the lead to 10, but here comes number 15.
Tim again.
With the two. He clearly means business here today.
He does. Get him in the paint, and he's putting it up every time.
Plymouth unfazed though, go for a three. Don't
and miss that, it. And that's rebounded by Bath, bringing it up. That's the IR there, and he's going for the drive. And unfortunately that's a travel, so that'll be a Plymouth ball.
Yeah, and he's not happy with the ref's call there.
No. We've got a couple of mouthy, is that the correct term, maybe, guys on the team.
They like to express themselves, they like to express their feelings.
Absolutely, they're passionate about their game and the sport.
Well, it certainly makes for an exciting game in the Founders Hall as Plymouth look for another opportunity just outside the D on the right-hand side. So they'll switch it, number
and
nine for
that's
three.
That's a wide open three there, but he misses it.
And now Bath have an opportunity. With time, 24.
Lovely no-look pass there to number 24 who sinks it. We'll see a bit more of that today, please.
That Bath 2 is certainly enjoying themselves if we only have about 40 seconds left on the clock. Plymouth look for an opportunity. Can't quite find it, but 11 drives into the middle, shoots.
And that's a lovely rebound there by the Bath team.
24.
They'll take that back up for a nearly wide open.
Oh! Number 30, Tim, using his physicality to...
Yeah, unfortunately that is a charge. So that's an offensive foul by 15 Bath, which is our man Tim, unfortunately.
Yeah.
He's coming a bit too strong into him.
Number 10 and Tim there, turn 10 from Plymouth, both hitting the deck. Perhaps he's a little bit overexcited.
A little bit, I say so. And that's a lovely steal.
Maybe for good reason as Bath win the ball with just over 20 seconds left in the first quarter.
Let's see if they can put another one up.
Number 30 collects. He's outside. Shoots for three.
And he makes
it! Lovely swish there. Reduces the deficit to three with 10 seconds left. Plymouth will look for one last opportunity on the right-hand side.
It's good defense by the Bath team. Not giving them any opportunity. Let's see if they'll
free
get one
go.
In with 3 seconds.
He does.
And he sinks it. And that's the end of the first quarter here in Founders Hall.
Well, a 5-point difference, an exciting start
to the game. Absolutely. We've certainly the clawed it back. It doesn't take long, as you were saying earlier.
Not at all, not at all. And it's good to see both benches getting a little bit more into it.
Absolutely.
Giving a little wave to your teammates there.
Yeah, they should be a bit louder. Let's hope they're listening and they can cheer up a little bit.
Listening in. Well, will you be? We sort of spoke about your performance earlier. Will you be happy with it?
Do you know, it's a tricky one. We certainly brought the energy towards the end of the game. Would be good to bring that earlier on.
Yeah.
But do you know, yes.
At this point of the season, you've still got a fair way to go, do you?
Yeah, absolutely. We're only halfway through the season now after that game, so we've played each team once. So we've got a lot of time left to bring it back.
And with such a tight loss there, do you reckon that'll make an exciting rematch later in the season?
I do. I think it'll make a really exciting rematch. Plymouth is our last game of the season, so we're playing them in February, and it will be away. So we're hoping that they don't bring the benches that they had earlier. And we just need to bring our focus and bring our rig in.
Well, if you are listening on URB, it is 26-21 to MARJON Plymouth against Barclay in the Founders Hall as we're approaching the second quarter. I think Barclay have played well so far, though.
I'd agree. They're keeping their focus, keeping it cool, playing well.
Here the players come for that second quarter. It's been a fast-paced game so far, lots of scoring. I mean, 26-21. Just in the first quarter. If we keep going at this rate, then it's
absolutely. It's going to be a high game.
Makes our job a lot easier.
Yeah, doesn't it just? Yeah, the boys are playing well, so let's hope they bring back.
Looks like maybe there's been a couple changes for Plymouth.
A couple of changes for Bath as well. We've got Nick, 31, back on the court. They're replacing Tim, giving him a break probably. Yeah. And Plymouth have got a couple of players we haven't seen before.
I think number two's come on. Number three's off. That impact player that he did try a couple of dunks in that first quarter.
He did. We'll see if any of the others
certainly getting into
in.
It.
Yeah, I think that'll be foul trouble. If he's already got two or three, the coach will probably want to keep him for later. So
yeah, well, 27 starting for Barclay. You said he's a good shooter, so hopefully he'll have a few shots in this next quarter.
Absolutely.
We're just waiting to get underway here.
Yeah. We've got a good set of 3-point shooters in the twos.
Here we go, the ref puts up his hand and Barclay look to get underway. They'll pass it back to 14.
That's like Captain Boris. He sends out to 24. They're in the corner, passing it round. And easy layup there.
Oh. The Barclay players expressing their feelings, as you did say earlier. They are a vocal lot.
They are. They're just passionate about the sport. And so that'll be a Plymouth end line ball.
Number two for Plymouth. I don't think he got any minutes in the first quarter.
No.
We did see him warming up. He was quite vocal, so you might see a bit of chippy play, I imagine, in this second quarter.
Yeah, absolutely.
Two refs just having a little
talk.
Yeah,
a little
there.
Conversation there. We have Stuart, who's our regular ref. He's pretty sound. We've got a new chap in today. He seems to be doing an all right job, but I'm biased, so.
Yeah, exactly. Well, it's 26-23 here to MARJON Plymouth. We've just started the second quarter. Barclay look eager to get underway.
Yeah. They look like they're having fun there on the court as well.
They do, and I imagine that's quite important to make sure their mentality doesn't slip in such an intense game.
Absolutely. So that's a lovely steal there, trapping the Plymouth player, so it makes a bad pass. It always goes down well. The boys seem to be passing it around.
14, looking for space, switches it to 27, back to 14, goes to the free, no he doesn't, he drives, now 24.
And a deep two there, reset the shot clock to 14, they'll carry on there, and that's a charge.
There we go. 24 there, dropping to his knees in almost celebration, shock.
Yeah, shock horror I think, wasn't expecting the charge to be given there, but from this point of view, you can see where it's taken a good shoulder into the Plymouth.
Freeze back onto the pitch now, Plymouth making a quick change, that pause in play. It's quite early to be making a change into the quarter.
Yeah, he's a key player for their team, he's probably giving them a break, but you can see why he's back on.
Freeze switches to 11. Free, we'll go for free.
And we'll miss that. And a bath rebound there with no one else in sight. And that's an easy 2 points.
half expecting 24 to go for a dunk there after what we've seen so far. Here comes Free charging, pushing up for Plymouth.
Yeah. And he'll take two there and miss that with a bad rebound. Plymouth defence is good, but they've got holes. Shown there by Nick, 31 with 2 points down.
And that puts Bath ahead for the first time since the first minute of the game.
That's what we like to see, easy play by Bath there.
27-26 to Bath. Here comes Free, he'll try to change it, and
easy 2 points, so they're back ahead, but I'm sure that won't be for long.
We mentioned earlier that the Bath ones did unfortunately lose to MARJON earlier in the season. You know, how much bragging rights will it give the twos here if they manage to beat Plymouth?
It will give them plenty of bragging rights. Absolutely. There's always been a close bit of competition between the ones and twos, particularly this season as they're both in the same.
Maybe some ammunition for the socials.
Oh, you bet. It'll be really interesting when we have another home game with the ones and the twos later on in the season. So that's a timeout there called by MARJON. They're clearly feeling the pressure. The coach is feeling the pressure. And I'm sure he's going to be having a stern word with them to stop leaving the Bath players open.
But you can see the Bath boys are really looking into it. They were sort of clapping as it came off and looked very, very happy with how they're playing.
Absolutely.
So far.
It's always a good sign for your team if the other team calls a timeout.
Now, if you were the Bath coach there, is there anything you'd look to do, change tactically, or would you just tell the boys to keep chipping away and keep going at it as they are?
Offensively, they're doing brilliantly. They're passing it around. They're making themselves open. They're taking good shots. Defensively, they could probably move around a bit more and make sure they're keeping on their guys, you know, make sure they're marking them properly. But other than that, no, I think you're absolutely right.
Yeah, and you said some stern words would be needed from MARJON. You know, what do you think will be going through those boys' minds?
I think they'll be probably frustrated themselves. They've gone from being, was it 8 points up at its most?
I think almost 10.
Almost 10, there you go. So I think dropping that down now to 1 point and back getting in the lead earlier, I think they'll be...
Both teams back onto the court. Plymouth just going out there a bit prematurely. Bath trying to slow down the game, would you imagine?
I'd say so. They want to keep it to their pace, not really rushing it.
That's a long pass.
That is a long pass. Makes it though. And Boris with another three, and that just misses it.
Bath with another change here. Tim, number 15, comes back on.
Back on the court.
The big friendly giant he is.
And that's a miss from Plymouth there, trying to make a three. And unfortunately, a bad step out of bounds there, so that'll be a Plymouth ball down their end.
Bath, and what do you say? Is there more like man defence?
Absolutely, yeah, they're playing man defence there.
Yeah.
The Bath teams have a really good help defence, so they tend to cover each other if they get past. Oh, and that's a three there by Plymouth.
Fantastic shot on the left-hand side.
Brings that up to a 4-point lead for Plymouth.
Shows just how quickly it can change in this game. As Bath trying to push the ball forward. 14 drives in, passes it to 15, moves it back out.
Yeah, good movement by the Bath team here. They swing it around to each other. And that's contact as he goes up for the shot and misses it, so he'll be shooting 2-3 throws there.
Number 24, he looks like one of the tallest players for Bath. Do you think height makes a difference to threes or not so much?
With threes, three pointers.
Yeah, or free throws, sorry.
Free throws, no, not really. Because you have the space to yourself.
Technique.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, it'd be important for us to get them. In fact, it's not a free throw, it's a.
Yeah, I don't really know what happened there, but evidently the ref didn't think he was shooting, so. We're back on the offense. The lovely take there, missed it, but they've got the rebound.
Bath moving the ball around the outside.
And that's a 3 point there, miss, and Plymouth get the ball.
Oh, lovely pass to 11, he was completely unmarked, so he'll go for
and
three.
And unfortunately aired that, but Plymouth get the rebound.
He doesn't let the feeling sit with him though, does 11, he straight away tried to get back in.
Absolutely.
Into the action.
Three tried to make the pass there, bounce off the back of the Bath guy's legs, unfortunately that went out, so it'll be a Plymouth ball from their end.
Number three drives in, looks to shoot, and gets two.
Really strong character there, number three. I know we've talked about him a lot already, but he's definitely getting most of the points up for the team.
I mean, in the women's game, we were talking a lot about number 14, who showed quite a lot of signs similar to number 3. Do you think that sort of physical style is quite akin to the Marjon philosophy?
Absolutely. I mean, number 14 was incredible. Her shots, I don't even think she missed. So you got to appreciate a good player on the court. But yeah, definitely, she was driving through, not afraid to weave through players and make a drive. So that's another sportsmanlike foul that's just happened there. I did pick up on that one. Apologies, everyone.
And it'll be number 2 shooting free throws. Goes for his first. Misses it.
In some ways, it's harder when you take three throws from non-sportsmanlike foul, because you've got no one there. You're not used to it. Feels a bit weird.
Yeah, exactly. A bit empty on the court. Well, let's see if he can make a second. And he misses both.
Bath will be pleased about that.
Maybe that empty environment getting to him a little bit.
Yeah, absolutely. So Bath are yet to score since the Plymouth timeout. So something must have changed there for the Plymouth boys.
Mm. And those changes in momentum can be so crucial in a game as tight as this.
Absolutely.
As Plymouth have the ball. 11 drives forward, shoots. Bath managed to knock it away and regain possession.
Bath taking the ball up there, back into there on the court. And the three there. Just misses that, and that's a Plymouth rebound, driving back up the other end. With a lovely pass there to 11. And that'll be an and one there.
It's number 31 tried to block it, but just got a bit too much contact, would you say?
Yeah, absolutely. That was quite a slap down on the wrist there, unfortunately, so there was no doubt about that one.
Good sportsmanlike conduct between the two, as he said sorry. Looks like we're
having a player change there. So that's Bailey coming on for number 16, coming on for 31, is getting taken off. I can imagine that's to do with that foul.
Bit of punishment for number 31 there.
Absolutely, but you only get 5 fouls before you can't play any longer. Happened to Serene earlier in the game on number 7. So
that free throw was sunk by Plymouth, making it 36. Bath might have something to say about it. They go up for 2, can't quite get there.
It's a lovely steal by 24 there. And he goes to the shot, misses it. And that'll be a Plymouth ball back down the other end.
Looking for a chance here. The ball just slips out of his hand, 24's completely unmarked. Oh, number 3.
It's a lovely little fake there.
3 was sent to the shops there, unfortunately. But it'll come straight back. Drives forward, looks for the 2, gets it.
3 there, making a lovely layup.
And that'll make it a 9-point deficit in the favour of Marjon. 38-29 here in the Founders Hall. 5 minutes left in the second quarter. I mean, it's not the biggest deficit we've seen in the game so far, so we can certainly see it fall.
Absolutely, I think it'll turn around.
Or at least we hope so, from a biased part.
And that's another 2 points. We're now 11 points down against Plymouth Marjon.
6 completely unmarked. Bath receives the ball, it goes to 15, Tim.
And that's a miss there, unfortunately, and Plymouth taking that back down the other end. I'd like to see a bit more rebounding from the Bath team. We're lacking there, and that's where we're missing out. That's a foul there. By number 15, that's Tim again. And that's his 3rd foul today.
So he'll have to be careful.
Absolutely.
He'll have to be careful.
Absolutely. It happens. To be fair, with the taller players, it's a little bit more difficult. They've got longer limbs, so it tends to be a foul.
Hard to rein themselves in. We were talking about Robin Yarmus, the new NBA player. He's got 7'3".
Yeah.
Something
wow,
crazy.
Crazy. He's playing like no 7'3" players ever played before in the NBA. It's great to see, actually. I can imagine a change of rules in the NBA chemistry. Anyway, both free throws were made by number 11 there for Plymouth. So we're heading back with the back ball. That's got stolen by Plymouth. And they're putting back up what would have been an easy few shots.
Ooh, heavy contact to the head of 2 there by 24 for Bath. 24 for Bath looks despondent. He's confused, but his arm did come into contact quite strongly with number 2 for Plymouth there.
You'll recognise that happens a lot with number 24. So Bath are now in foul trouble. That does mean that if any fouls occur on the court before before the end of the game with 4.5 minutes left, then it will result in shooting.
How much of a risk is that for Bath to go a player down at this stage of the game when there's a 15-point deficit on the board?
Well, so they've still got a full court. It's not too much of an issue. They've still got a full team on, full squad on the pitch, but it does mean that if any fouls are made now, it will result in free throws, which is just easy points, easy baskets. That's Plymouth coming up. Bit of a treble there, I would have said. But clearly the refs aren't seeing that.
Plymouth ball here is 24. He's been very vocal going to tie up his shoelace.
And that's a timeout there called by Bath. Understandably, we're now currently 16 points down to Plymouth Orton.
Yeah, a bit of a flip. We haven't seen Bath put up too many points in the start of
It's been a shame to see, I think.
What's gone wrong?
I think unfortunately a lot of shots being taken and being missed.
Yeah.
And
do you say
sometimes that just
it's maybe less of the Bath boys slowing down, more of the Marjon boys just speeding it up?
I would say that's a really good point. I think so, but also the Marjon boys being really really physical, really aggressive, and the Bath boys aren't giving any of that back. They're not quite there defensively. They seem to have lost that motion. So hopefully they'll pick that up before the end of this quarter.
Yeah, well, we spoke to one of the players before the game, number 30, and he described that sometimes towards the end of the game they can start playing a style that they like to call hero ball. Maybe a little bit swing and a miss every now and again. Do you think the coach will be trying to just make sure that they're staying calm? And
yeah, absolutely. We've got a full squad today. We've got a full 12 men, so we've got lots of rotations that can be happening. So there's no need to wear ourselves out or rush it.
Yeah, and at this point in the season, sort of halfway through, how risky are as an injury to the team?
It's risky, especially with one of our key players, but as I said, we've got a deep bench, we've got a lot of great players in the Bath team, the M2s, so...
There we go. Well, players coming back onto the court with 4 minutes 18 left on the clock in the second quarter. It is 45 Marjon to 29 Bath. Unfortunately, Bath trailing by 16 points here in Founders Hall.
And with 5 fouls on the board.
Not a place you'd want to be.
No, not a place you'd want to be at all.
And they'll look to defend this as well, so that deficit could be extended by Plymouth.
So that's a Plymouth ball in their offensive zone. So let's see if the Bath boys can get a steal here.
11, potentially looking up to set up a play.
And that's 5 seconds there, so Plymouth taking too long to pass the ball in. So that'll transfer to a Bath ball from the end line.
They were trying to sort of set something up there a bit too hard, maybe not playing the ball as naturally.
Yeah, maybe. Set plays tend to work.
Here comes Bath, pushing down the field, drives into the centre, 30.
That's a lovely basket there by 30. So Plymouth will take that back up to their end of the court.
Plymouth holding possession, 7 drives in, shoots.
And misses that, but Plymouth get the rebound and will score that. Good bit of physicality for the Plymouth team there.
Well, here is Bath. 7, moves it up to 16.
And 30 will shoot, miss that. But unfortunately the Plymouth team there get the rebound and they'll take that straight down the other end. 2v3 there, so that's an easy basket for Plymouth.
Looks like Bath are trying to get a bit of communication going here on the pitch that Plymouth maybe have a bit more seamlessly.
Yeah, absolutely. I think it's really tricky when, you know, we've got a really relatively new team here. So that's 3 taken by 16 and unfortunately missed that. But Bath will get the rebound. Unfortunately that will be stolen by Plymouth.
The ball moving, we've seen the two teams quite a bit in that last
you see a lot of that. It's what we call a bit of a scuffy game when everyone's on their knees and really key to their team.
Managed to put another 2 up to move Marjon to above 50 points and extend that deficit to 20 over Bath with just over 2.5 minutes left on the clock in this second quarter.
Bath trying to lob that in to get a dunk in there, but completely missed by Jimmy, unfortunately.
There's been no dunks successfully pulled off so far.
No, I'm waiting to see one, but I think it's unfortunately, well, I would say too tight of a game. We're now Bath is now down by 20 points. It's 51-31 here in Founders Hall.
3-11 partnership that's been successful so far, but this 2 won't go in. rebound won by 24 for Bath as he pushes up, beats three in the one-on-one and lays it up.
That is a beautiful drive by Yaya there.
Three straight back to the other side, goes to shoot.
Lovely rebounded by the Bath team. Lovely, picking the pace up here. And that's a foul on Jimmy. He'll be shooting from the line.
Bit of friendly fire between the two Bath boys there going for the ball. A bit of a collision.
Yeah,
shows
absolutely.
they're eager to get into it.
They're willing to roll on the floor and try get it.
Well, number 30, we spoke to him pre-game about his free throw shooting ability and he seemed pretty confident.
He's been proving me wrong so far. That's his second round of three throws.
See if he can make these.
And he makes his first one.
Number 30, I think that's his. He's free from three so far at the free throw line.
He's got a few issues with the table there.
For our listeners who don't quite know, can you just explain about the table?
Yeah, so we have three 10-to-be players who will table our games. One who does the score sheet, one who does the scoreboard, and the one who does the shot clock.
Shows the good community of Bucks sport here at the university as Bertie goes for a second free throw.
And there's that, unfortunately.
Oh, misses the first one, wow. He'll bounce back, we're sure.
Absolutely.
It's Plymouth ball, though.
Yeah, Plymouth ball sidelined. They'll be aiming to get that back up as quickly as possible and get some more points and to extend their lead.
51-34 to MARJON Plymouth as number one tries to push up but leaves the ball behind him.
Ooh, so could have been seen as a foul there, but thankfully not, because that's the bad side fouling there. And that's an easy putback for number 10 for Plymouth.
Here comes the number 24, who's been so much about the bar. Bust it to 16 to 30. Bath looking for space, they'll go for the three.
And missed that with no rebounders inside, unfortunately. So that'll be Plymouth heading back up. And that's a steal by Bath. He'll take the ball back up again at the end.
Bath look to shoot. Too many Plymouth bodies in there and they'll lose it.
Getting blocked, unfortunately. And that's a travel by Plymouth.
Twice in a row there on those Bath attacks that they've been a bit crowded.
Absolutely.
Take some time and spread out a little bit.
Spread out, pass the ball out, ease themselves.
You don't want it to be like a primary school football game when you've got about 10 lads all running
no,
up to the same
absolutely.
Ball. Here come Bath looking for an opportunity. Six takes the three, drives forward. Doesn't quite manage to get there.
But he will be taking free throws there with a foul.
Six of a chance to reduce this 19-point deficit to Plymouth MARJON with just over 1 minute left in the second quarter of the game.
So number six, Jake, taking free throws there.
First free throw of the game, I think, for Jake there. And he'll just miss out on his first one. How important is it to get the first, or is there not much to it?
It's not much to it. It does tend to line up your second quite well. And that's a miss at the second one there, unfortunately.
Plymouth will be straight back in the Bath D looking for a shot. Don't quite manage to put it off, though.
So that's a foul by number six.
An offensive foul by Plymouth there.
I think that was a defensive. Yeah, foul
My
by
bad.
Number six there. So Plymouth will be shooting now. With three throws.
Number one here. I think it's the first time we've seen him from the free throw line as well.
Yeah, absolutely.
Much like number six of Bath, not very successful on his
first
shot.
No, missed the first one.
Let's see if he can put up the second.
And he'll make that. So that's extending that to a 20-point lead for Plymouth.
Bath
having a good series of passing. Oh, that would have been a lovely shot. Fortunately missed by Jimmy, number 30. And Plymouth will take it back down the other end. Bath failing to rebound again, so let's hope they pick that up going into the second half. That was a lovely spin move by 11.
Plymouth maybe just finishing off those moves a little bit better than Bath. They've just got
that
extra edge. It's a long ball. Bath to move
really
it up.
Nice pass there, and a foul by 14 on Bath number 7, so he'll be shooting.
There's been quite a few fouls in this sort of dying moments of this second
absolutely.
Quarter.
Absolutely. I think towards the end of a quarter, it can get a bit hustly. People are wanting the ball much more.
Well, with a 22-point difference, let's see if Bach can sort of close it down here with the first free throw.
And unfortunately, he'll miss that.
Let's see if number 7 can put up his second. And it is good. Bosch still hanging in this. They're not giving up despite what is sort of a growing deficit in this second quarter.
Absolutely. They're giving it their all. I think Plymouth are starting to warm up to the court. And that's a foul by 24 there, so that'd be his third foul. Not good going into the second half.
No. He does not look happy. He's having a little word with the referee here.
Chat. See where he went wrong. So unfortunately, Bath are on 5 fouls. So although that wasn't a shooting foul, Plymouth will be shooting free throws.
Let's see if Plymouth can make it count. Number 1 will put up his first free throw with ease.
Plymouth seeming very confident there. They've got none of their guys in the. Oh, there we go. They're moving in now. And that makes that
58-35, a 23-point difference with 20 seconds left on the clock. Bath got maybe one more opportunity, and it'll go for 3. Can't quite get there.
Unfortunately, no rebounders there again. I'm sure that'll be something that Coach Justin mentions at halftime.
10 seconds left on the clock. Plymouth, are they going to hold on? Instead, they go for the 3. Beautiful shot by 1 there. Bath won't get the chance to go for another one, or will they?
But he will be shooting free throws.
And there we go. Well, the clock's run out, so these will be the last sort of bit of play in the first half.
Absolutely.
Do you think they're important just to get a little bit of a sort of
Oh, 100%. Yeah. You need any points you can get, yeah. So we'll take that if we can.
Keep it close.
And that's a miss on that first one.
7, let's see if we can get a second. Oh, and it's a double miss
that
unfortunately
again.
And that will be the first half, end of the second quarter at Founders Hall. If you're listening to URB or watching on Campus TV, it is 35-61 to Marjon against Bath here. What a first half.
Yeah, there's a lot to take from that first half. We managed to keep it up in the first quarter, ended that quite successfully.
Yeah.
And we got up at one point, but unfortunately, Plymouth have just massively extended.
Plenty of scoring, and like you said, Bath did briefly hold the lead there at the start of the second quarter or end of the first.
Yeah, definitely.
Do you think it's impossible for Bath to get themselves back into this game and look for a win?
No, I definitely think it can happen. It's been done before. I'm sure it will be done again. The boys just need to really get in the game and get focused.
And for that to happen, what tactical changes would you think are needed, or would you like to see?
Well, so as I mentioned, defensively we need some rebounding going on. Offensively we also need some rebounding going on. So the boys are shooting and then just there's no one in there to pick it back up again.
Yeah. We saw a little bit of crowding as well, I thought.
Yeah, absolutely. We're getting a bit stuck. One of the things that Bath does quite well is we have some quite good passing, so I'd love to see some more ball movement on offense rather than just going straight up for the shots.
Both sort of supporting fans are getting a little bit more into it as well, which is quite good to see.
Absolutely. We really need the fans. It really helps drive up the atmosphere. Towards the end of my game, you know, the fans were really getting involved, and it always helps.
Yeah. And let's talk a little bit about that game. It was a tough close-fought contest.
Absolutely.
How would you sort of rank your own performance in that?
Do you know, I won't lie, not my best performance, but defensively, I felt like I really helped out the team today. But as a team, we performed really, really well. We came back strong. And our energy was there throughout. We've got a lot of things that we've taken away that we know we need to work on, so we'll be practicing that over the next week before our next game here next week.
Yeah, sounds good. Well, we're gonna take a little break here. But we'll be back for the second half in about 8 minutes. Thank you. are back on air here at Founders Hall for the second half of the men's twos basketball against Marjon ones. It was a very exciting first half.
Absolutely, very exciting. Unfortunately, Plymouth have drawn up the lead and they're now leading
quite
by 26 points. Yeah, absolutely. So let's see what these both boys can do and see if they can bring it back.
A bit of excitement at halftime there as well. We were expecting more of a 10-minute half, ended up with five.
Yeah, absolutely. The refs are raring, ready to go on the court, just waiting for the players now.
Any predictions for the second half?
I don't want to jinx it, so I won't say anything.
What about a bit more niche? I reckon we'll definitely see some more three-point attempts.
Absolutely. I'd love to see some dunks. A bit of dunk play going on.
Number three looked very eager for Plymouth in the first half.
Absolutely, absolutely.
But after being denied on back-to-back plays, it's going to knock your confidence a little bit.
He seems to have discontinued that attempt, but we'll see if he tries to put it back in.
Did you get to have a word of any of the players in half?
I saw a couple, and I just said, keep your heads up, boys. Keep going. Unfortunately, their shots, which normally would go in today, just aren't hitting. So we'll see if they've had a break in the halftime. And off again. So we're off again. Plymouth got the ball.
Try forward number three. Looks for the shot. Doesn't pull it off as he falls through the ground. And Bath will now push on the other side. Seven.
So he'll take that
space
out. And they'll spin that round. And Tim going in. And that's a lovely shot by Tim.
Perfect way to start the second half of Bath.
Absolutely,
there.
Yeah. We'll have a few more of those, please.
Reduce that deficit only down to 24, but any reduction is beneficial as number 11 for Plymouth on the edge of the D looks for space.
And that's three going in for a drive. And 11 taking a three-point, and he missed that, and that's received by the Bath team. So they'll take it back up to their end of the court.
Bath 2s really seem to be using momentum throughout the game here. These sort of spells of, you know, being really on top of Plymouth and then maybe struggling after. Is that
Absolutely.
Something they've got to smooth out?
Yeah, I think so. I think we need a greater rotation of players on the court. You know, when they're getting tired from that defence, you know, we've got a good bench. We've got lots of people we can swap in. That's a lovely pass there by 7 into 15, Tim, who's just scored 2 points. And Plymouth will take it back up the other end.
Number 11 being an influential player, manages to get two for Plymouth.
Very easy extra 2 points.
And it's a Plymouth ball.
Yes.
Tim getting visibly frustrated with his teammates there, but I think the unity is still there between the boys.
Absolutely, absolutely. I mean, there's moments of frustration.
It shows how much this game means to them.
Yeah, definitely.
With 8 minutes 30 on the clock, number three drives forward for Plymouth. Won't get there.
That's a Bath foul on number three.
We'll have an opportunity to get some free throws in here, will he? Or no?
Yeah, I know, and I think no, so he'll
be a jump.
They'll be taking that from the end line. I think that's by number 15. So that could be his fourth foul.
Tim.
It's not going so well for Tim today.
He's
put
on thin
some
ice.
Great shots up, but he might be in foul trouble soon.
An emotional game, to say the least.
Absolutely.
As Plymouth play the ball in, trying to move it round quickly there on the left-hand side. It'll go to 10 in the middle. He shoots up, it's blocked, goes again.
That's impressive. Three Bath boys in there, but Plymouth 10 gets the rebound on his own. Let's hope that they get more in there for those rebounds and start making them.
7 for Bath. Looks for the pass for 6, doesn't quite get there. And
physical frustration again from the Bath team. I think they need to calm down. They need to trust their own instincts.
Only 2 minutes into the second half.
Absolutely,
as well.
Absolutely. I feel like they're carrying on the energy from the first half, and they need to relax and trust their play because they can do it.
Yeah, exactly. Well, it'll be a Plymouth ball here as one shifts it back to three. He'll try and drive forward, beat his man 16 on the right hand side. Play it forward to 10. Cut inside, but he'll take a step out of bounds. And it'll be a Bath ball.
Yeah.
How easy is that a mistake to make? Just let one foot a little bit wide.
It's very easy, especially in Bath because our lines aren't properly marked. So we're playing to the wrong lines here.
To paint the picture a little bit here is Plymouth go for three unsuccessfully. There's quite a few sports that are played in the Founders Hall here.
Yeah, absolutely.
So there's lots of lines going on.
That's another three by Bath going up there, and that's a miss, unfortunately. Yeah, so unfortunately our lines aren't aren't drawn quite right, so we play to netball on the sidelines. But other than that, we're good. And that's 11 deep two.
By number 11, 31 from Bart. Congratulating him on that one. Good to show some sportsmanlike
conduct
between the two. 26 drives into the middle for Bath, goes for the two.
And that's a lovely rebound by Tim there. He'll send that out to his teammates. Lovely. And they'll go for a three there by number seven, which will miss, but that's rebounded by Tim yet again. And unfortunately stolen by number 11.
Three, will he go for the dunk?
And he won't. He's playing it safe.
We've grown accustomed to him going for those bigger shots, maybe on this
steal,
time.
Though.
And there he goes.
There's our first dunk of the game.
He was eager to get that one, wasn't he? Driving up for the centre for that dunk.
In the confidence, his teammates were there. And
there goes Tim.
A semi-dunk from Tim. He nearly quite made it. Not as impressive as threes, I won't lie. But
he didn't quite have to jump for that.
No.
The MARJON have managed to extend the lead to 71-41 here at Founders Hall with 6:30 on the clock. But Plymouth, it's a silly mistake there as Bath managed to get the steal. 16 driving through the centre.
And that's unfortunately a miss there, and Plymouth get the rebound.
Three's wide open. He's got 11 next to him if he needs. Instead, he'll move it back to 10. 10 drives through, goes for the two.
That's a lovely drive there, but he misses, and Bath get that rebound.
Well, here goes Tim in the centre.
And that's a three-point shot gone up, and he missed there, unfortunately. And 31 makes that shot there. I feel Bath could relax a little bit on the three-pointers.
Yeah,
they've got a good team base who are making good drives, so they can continue with that.
Hero ball, as they described it themselves.
Absolutely, yeah.
You don't want to get too trigger happy as number three passes to one, who does go for a three.
And misses that again, so that'll be rebounded by Bath, who'll be bringing the ball back up.
Tim using his height over number 14 there for Bath, will step inside instead, passes back out to six for the three.
And that's another miss, unfortunately, but Hansen goes out of bounds.
And there'll be a change here for Plymouth, all there.
And Bath as well, bringing on their captain Boris. Number and Shooter 27. Still waiting to see him put some shots at them.
Yeah. Well, there's been plenty of shots firing, so I wouldn't be surprised if we see him try his hand as number three pushes forward here for Plymouth, who switch it to 11, now to one, with a lovely bit of a crossover.
By the Plymouth team, and nearly a steal there by Boris.
Bounce pass there.
He misses that, and that gets stolen by Bath. He'll take the ball up. And they'll get passed out to Boris in the corner for a three, and that's a miss, unfortunately, with a rebound by Plymouth, who'll be taking back up the other end.
Number three for Plymouth. He's going to go for a three-pointer now. Instead, he gives it to one who drives into the middle and pass to 11. Is that a dunk?
That was a dunk. That was a lovely dunk by 14.
There we go.
You can't deny it. Puts a smile on everyone's face on both teams.
It does.
Teams.
Everyone enjoys a good dunk.
It's always nice to see.
We might see another one here as 11's got a break. Does he go for it?
No. Simple put back up and misses, but Plymouth gets the ball.
Three on the outside. He'll switch it. Plymouth will attempt a three there. Tim for Bath almost not expecting the steal there, but Plymouth will quickly regain possession. Holding onto the ball, using that communications.
Yeah. Plymouth team playing really well together. You can tell they're a really well-bonded team.
Goes for the three. They'll get the rebound. Or will they?
That'll be knocked out of bounds by the Bath team, so that'll be Plymouth ball. And subs coming on.
Number three will come off for Plymouth, that impact player. Looks like he did. I'm not surprised he needs a rest after that dunk.
Absolutely. Running backwards and forwards, making steals. He deserves a break.
Well, with 4 minutes left in this third quarter, it is 73 MARJON to 43 Bath. And that deficit could be increased even more as number eight goes for a three-pointer for Plymouth and sinks it.
Yeah, deep two there. But
deep
certainly
two.
points on the board, that's for sure.
Like you say, it is unfortunate in the commentary position. We can't quite tell if it's a two or three.
We haven't got the best view from up here. And that's a foul by number nine. Reaching across there on 14 for blue. So that'll be a sideline ball for Bath.
And do you think either team are starting to tire a little bit in this second half? Or
honestly, not particularly. The MARJON team have clearly got a lot of strength, a lot of energy there. Bath team possibly, but they've got the bench to put more players on to give their players a rest. So
if they need it, they can use it.
Absolutely.
Well, Bath ball here, is it?
That is a Bath ball from the sideline. Passing out to number 14, Boris, who will take it, hold on to it and put up for three, which he misses. We're unfortunately missing a lot of our three-pointers. Let's hope that turns around.
Look for an opportunity to shoot. Does number 9 instead? He switches it to 14. He's blocked by Tim.
So that is another foul there for Tim.
Is that, how many fouls is that? Does that put him on for this second half?
It's first one for the second half.
First one for the second half. After a first half full of fouls.
Absolutely.
Well, number 14's got the chance to get some points for Plymouth here from the free throw line.
I think that could be Tim's fourth foul there, so he is in foul trouble now. And that's an easy basket by 14. First free throw.
See if he can get another one to get two from two. Move the deficit to 78-43 to Marjon with 3.5 minutes left on the clock. It does with ease.
It does indeed make it.
And it'll be brought off, so he'll get a breather after that. As
well deserved break for two easy points. So
Plymouth bring on their number 5.
And number 30 for Bath has come on as well, giving Tim a break.
It's a Bath ball here.
I think there's a problem with the tabling there. Resetting the shot clocks and making sure they're right.
This is Bucks, unfortunately, not the NBA. The basketball is still just as entertaining, I'm sure. But we do have some technical errors every now and again as Bath start with possession. 24 with a long ball to the right hand side. 30 collection just been brought on and passed to 31.
Lovely movement by the Bath team there, and a foul made by number 5, who's only just come on. Clearly Plymouth are far enough ahead now, they can give their star players a rest and push on some of their less experienced players.
Yeah, sort of build that squad depth looking towards the second half of the season.
Absolutely, giving them some game time as well.
Nevertheless, Bath have got a couple of opportunities in the free throw line here, courtesy of 31.
It's the first one missed, unfortunately, but we'll see what he does with the second one.
Here he goes, he's got a second opportunity here to get Bath to 44 points to Marjon 78.
Unfortunately, that's another miss with a Plymouth rebound. They come straight down the court. Unfortunately, slips from his hand, and that's a Bath ball. 30 going up for the three-pointer and misses that, and that's another Plymouth rebound. Where will we see our Bath rebounders?
Yeah, Bath aren't really trying to get those rebounds. They're not trying to keep the play alive, you might say. Plymouth go for another three, don't quite miss, but they're there for the rebound once again.
Absolutely.
Both offensively and defensively.
And that's an easy layup going through.
And skips in for those 2 points.
Number 5.
Bath number 14 pushes up, lobs it over to 30. 30 cuts inside with a big pass to the outside.
Pass 31, back into 14 inside the 3-point line. We'll pass to 31 again. We'll try a post move there and unfortunately miss. So that'll go back to Plymouth going down the other end.
Plymouth attempt the three there, but unsuccessfully.
A nice Bath rebound there.
There we go. Count that one on the post.
Absolutely. Start going back down our end. So that's what we like to see.
Of course,
that's a good steal by Plymouth there, and they go back up.
And they managed to.
So a foul by 30. I think he just hit him with his hip.
The high fives audible from the commentary box. You can see that the Plymouth Marjon having a good time. Almost 40 points ahead. If number 9 manages to put this free throw up, then yeah, that will be over a 40 point deficit with 2 minutes left to play in this
Absolutely.
Third quarter.
That's Captain Boris going off there for Jake number 6 coming on.
Number 2 coming on for Plymouth, who managed to pull off a dunk earlier, I think.
So that's a Bath rebound there for a missed Plymouth ball. So let's hope that Bath can make some movement with this. They go for another three and unfortunately miss that, but Bath do get the rebound this time.
Let's see if they can make something work here. They go for another three, doesn't quite work. Bath a bit
put
trigger
back
happy.
Though. Yeah, absolutely, but we've got a good rebound there by Nick, 31, who put backs and gets that back in there.
Number 9 charges, drives forward for Plymouth. Past the number 2, tries to use some physicality but doesn't pay off.
No, unfortunately that's Bath going up for rebound and just dropping it out of his hand, so that'll be a Plymouth ball from the end line.
Would Bath, do you reckon they need the crowd to get a bit more behind them?
I think so. I think our crowd's a bit quiet here today. I think they could be a bit louder.
Founders Hall, perhaps not providing the same atmosphere as Madison Square Garden.
Not quite.
As number one puts up a 2-pointer there for Plymouth.
It is difficult to be positive when you are 40 points down.
Yeah, it's hard to say 0-0 lads when it's a 40-point deficit.
Absolutely. We're missing a couple of passes here. We just need to get back together, recollect ourselves and enjoy the game this afternoon.
We did mention 27 earlier and his shooting ability. I haven't seen him pull off too many shots
yet. No, I don't think he's put one up yet today. There may
still
be injuries
still
there.
Plenty of time in the
Absolutely.
In the final quarter, but in this third one we've only just got a minute left as Plymouth sort of stroll in before driving quickly to the basket. Number one goes up for two, but can't quite get
there. That's a good block there from 24 Yaya, who knocks the ball out of court. So Plymouth will take it from the end line.
It'll be number two to put it into play. That'll be quick to 13, we'll move it out of the outside to one, outside the D. Is he going to go for three instead of drive? Pass backwards.
Plymouth team know where their players are.
At this point, when a margin is this great in a game, can you start to afford to taking risks and maybe practicing some plays?
Absolutely. As I said, as Plymouth are so far up, they're putting on their less experienced players. They're giving them some good play time. It's a good opportunity to practice some plays so you can work on things for the next game.
There we go. Well, with 40 seconds left, here goes one again. He's had a very good third quarter, but that shot was not so good.
That's a foul by one there on 31 Nick. So that'll be a sideline ball for Bath.
Bath with just over 30 seconds left in this third quarter to try and get some points up and maybe get themselves over that 50-point mark, as it's 86 Marjon currently to 47 Bath. Three fouls from both teams. Do you reckon it's been a bit of a cleaner?
Yeah, much, much cleaner quarter this one.
Bath move it round, looking for an opportunity to shoot.
That's a steal there by Plymouth though, and they'll head back up.
Long ball to number two, goes to the pass to five, we'll put it up for 2 points. Well, we're 15 seconds left. Bath have got to be quick if they want to get something out of this third quarter.
Absolutely. 15 seconds, they've got time though, but unfortunately that's a carry there by number 24 Bath, so that'll be a Plymouth sideline.
Well, it's been an emotional game to see the least for 24.
Absolutely. He's, as I said before, very passionate.
It's good to see the passion on the court. It's always good to see passion on the court. And a friendly contest so far between the two teams.
Yeah, definitely.
Well, 5 seconds left. Plymouth holding on to position. You can hear the count. Counting down, and that's it.
The end of that quarter there.
The quarter. Well, a disappointing start to the second half of Bath, potentially.
Absolutely. But Plymouth are just showing their strength here. They came top of the table last season. So we're expecting a really tough game from them when they fought it for the battle.
And in terms of this season, how are Plymouth getting on? Are they expecting another table topping year?
Well, again, so far they're top of the table, I believe.
And as was mentioned earlier, they did manage to beat the Bath Ones. Do you know the Bath Ones score off the top of your head?
I don't, but I'm sure I could find out for us.
See if our Bath Twos are putting up an equal performance.
Yeah.
Let's hope so. It's been an exciting game so far, nonetheless. And would you say, if you are in a position like this when you're in the twos, when you're playing the best side in the league, that even if you're losing, that experience alone is very valuable.
Oh, absolutely. Playing against such a tough competitors, lots and lots of experience, and allows you to work on, see where you're dropping things and where we're missing things, and give you some things to work on in training.
Awesome. So, if you could tell us a little bit about the ambitions, I suppose, for Bath Basketball Society at the uni. What do the different teams want this year?
Absolutely. Well, the ones aiming to move up into the Premier Division. We've had a couple of times where we've made it to playoffs from Tier 1, but never quite got out of Tier 1. So we're always aiming to move up to the Prem.
Yeah.
And for the twos, it will be to stay in Tier 1. For us, it's to remain in Tier 1 for another season. Last year, we had a historic season, our best yet. We're not quite performing to that level, but I'm sure we'll be bringing it before the end of the season.
Is there one side as well in British sort of BUCS basketball that's dominant? I know in British professional basketball, is it the British Lions tend to put everyone else away most of the time?
Absolutely. It depends. In this division, in the men's Western Tier 1, it's definitely Plymouth Margin. They definitely dominate most teams. And that'll be a foul there from 13 as we're back in play in the fourth quarter.
88 Marjon to 47 Bath. A large deficit, to say the least, but at the same time, Bath are staying relentless and they'll have a chance to cut that deficit down at least two here with a couple of free throws from number 24.
Absolutely. So the Bath ones currently sit top of the table, but that due to their them playing five games and Plymouth only the three.
Let's see if our Bath twos are putting up a performance, you know. Maybe a bit close than the Bath ones, or you know, on the flip side, maybe not so close, as Plymouth get the rebound from that free throw and will immediately go on the attack.
And they're coming at the other end now.
Plymouth not slowing down, still ramming that ball down Bath's throat.
And that's a lovely steal there by number 13 on the Bath squad.
Number 31 for Bath here, looks for a pass option, can't quite find it. So I'll move to the outside. But a lovely three-pointer there by Bath. And number 31 calmly moves back. Oh, and a nice little steal there by 24 for Bath. And 27, we mentioned his shooting ability.
Fortunately, misses that. It gets blocked by number 2.
Commentator's curse. Live in action.
Absolutely.
A little bit chippy there between 30 from Bath and 2 from Plymouth. Maybe some first signs of frustration showing as we enter the final 9 minutes of this contest.
It's nice to see Bath get over the 50-point mark, though.
Yeah, definitely. Well, I mean, they've still scored quite a bit. I mean,
that's a lovely block there, which puts the ball back in Bath hands. And it goes for a shot, and that's an easy 2 points by number 6, Jake.
I'll move Bath up to 53 as Plymouth start out from their half of the court. Number 2.
Bath seem to have a good dynamic on the court now. The team's really easy into its motion.
Do you think this five that are currently on are maybe gelling together a bit better than the previous?
Absolutely.
Ones?
I mean, it takes time. You know, yeah. When you get on fresh on the court, it takes time to build in with the players you're working with. So that's a three gone up there, and that's missed by Plymouth, and that's caught by Bath,
messy
and they're down
pass.
The other end.
Will they go for the shot? No. Instead, it's knocked out of play there, was it?
Yeah. So that'll be a Bath ball end line.
Bath looking to get any opportunity they can here. I mean, they've managed to knock it down to 35 points, so it's not quite the 40 it was.
No.
But at the same time, they'll definitely want it to be a bit more competitive as it is a Bath ball here.
Yeah, absolutely.
From the halfway line.
Interesting to see that the M1 team only lost by 3 points to Plymouth Rodham.
Oh, so it's quite a close game, a bit similar to the women's game that we saw and you played in just prior to this.
Yeah, definitely. So that'll be a really interesting rematch towards the end of the season where the M1s play in Plymouth home. Unfortunately, the shot clock has run out there.
It looked good from Bath, though, there. They were sort of trying to get a play going from what we could sort of
absolutely
see up here. Communication looks to be improving early. We did see perhaps those channels lacking a little bit.
Yeah, definitely. Defensively, you always need to keep the chatter up. And they seem to be doing a better job of that offensively as well.
And I think it was mentioned that the Bath, the men's twos coach, was the women's coach last year. So, I mean, have you played under him?
Yes, yeah. I played under Justin for 1 year. Great coach. It's a shame that he chose to leave us and move on to the twos. But he seems to be doing a great job with them, so it's really nice to see.
Exactly. And it's a project, I suppose, going forward for the rest of the year.
Definitely. Interesting challenge as well for him with so many new players.
5 seconds left on the shot clock for Bath. They go
put
for the
a three in and it's made.
Sink it.
By number 6, Jake.
He looks very, very happy with that.
Yeah, finally putting some of those in.
Bath just slowly chipping away at the Marjon defence, but Marjon will look for an opportunity to score here.
That's a lovely block by 31, Nick.
24, but he's got 27 to his right. Instead, he chooses to go all the way.
And he makes it.
Bath building a little bit of momentum here.
Yeah, it's nice to see. They really can do it.
Oh, here they go. 24, he's got no one around him. Will he go for the dunk? Oh, no. Just a two.
No, just an easy two.
We were eager for a dunk in the commentary box, or at least I was there.
That's a timeout for the Plymouth side.
30 points up, you know, and 90 points up.
Absolutely. I mean, at this point in the game, it's all about bringing that deficit down so that later on in the season, if it does come to points and deficit, then they're in a better position.
if you are the Marjon coach, is there a point when you start looking at injury prevention perhaps and maybe slowing the game down a little bit, taking the sting out?
Absolutely. I think that time has probably been and gone. You know, the 40-point lead was probably it.
Yeah.
And he's probably saying, you know, come on, we can do better than this.
Can they afford to take, you know, maybe have a little bit of fun?
Absolutely.
Risk some plays that otherwise you wouldn't really be able to.
I'd like to see some more dunking going on. Yeah. So we would love to see a bit more of that on the court. But I think clearly the coach has called the timeout. He's not happy with their play, so I think it will probably become a little bit more serious from them.
Yeah, exactly. But even if you've got your, you know, potentially your second team on the pitch, you still want them to be executing.
Absolutely, absolutely. And improving their play, you know. So we'll see what they get up to.
Yeah, well, we're just under 7 minutes on the clock here in the Founders Hall. It is 92 Marjon, 62 Bath. Bath haven't put a foul up yet. I mean, it's been the cleanest quarter we've had so far.
Absolutely. I think everyone's getting a bit tired, so they're making sure to back off a bit so it doesn't get too sloppy on the court.
As the boys come out here, with just under 7 minutes remaining. We hope you're enjoying. If you're listening on URB or tuning in on Campus TV, this is the second of the two games we have broadcast today. First being the women's unfortunate loss to Marjon by 1 point earlier in the day. And it'll be a Plymouth call to start us back off here. With number two pushing up the court, switches it to five. He looks to go for a free, doesn't have space, so he'll move back to two. We'll go to the locker.
Good movement by Plymouth there, swinging it around to find the hole in the defence, and they do with a three from number five.
Potentially just letting Bath sort of fall on their own sword there, maybe a bit of lack of communication.
Absolutely.
But here come Bath. 24 taking his time, moves it to 30. Calls for a number six. He was going to hand it off there, that could have been messy. So 5 seconds left on the shot clock, they'll go for three.
And unfortunately missed that, but they're putting it back up. And that's tough, but that is unfortunately a Plymouth ball from the end line.
Bath did manage to get a couple of rebounds in there though.
Absolutely, yeah, and tried putting them back up, but one got blocked and one unfortunately did make it. So let's hope that turns around.
Yeah. Plymouth a little goose step there to move forward. One goes for the three-pointer.
And makes that. It. Lovely shot there by number one. And they make the steal from the end line and go up again with another three for number one and makes that as well.
Two in a row. He's a player that was playing very well in the earlier in the half. Do you think he's been brought back on just to reinstall that sting in the game?
Possibly, yeah. Make sure the rest of the team is playing up to that high standard that they want to be at and to make sure they've got someone there who's shooting and putting shots up. Well, that is a miss, unfortunately, there. Missed 3-point shots. Plymouth will be taking that back down there.
Certainly worked, though, as one drives forward again. There's another free attempt. Doesn't quite pull off.
And Plymouth still have the ball. And
another 3-pointer. Again, doesn't quite work out.
The bench distracting them. Seems to be working quite well.
And the ref blows up there. It's going to be a couple of changes for Bath here as 16 comes on and Tim, number 15, comes on as well. Bath have got some tall boys in there, so hopefully they'll be getting some rebounds.
Absolutely.
But here come Plymouth, eager to get the action back started. One will go for a third three-pointer, sinks it again. That to take them over the century mark to 102 to Bath 60.
Yeah, it's a strong play by Plymouth in the last few minutes of the quarter. They're going down for another one.
Number two.
With a possible foul there as well, which thankfully for him hasn't been called.
Marjon really racing ahead now, but Bath not giving up, not dying down. They'll put a two up there.
And that's a lovely two by 31, Nick.
At what point in the game do you start to feel like if you're on the losing side that you've just got to keep pushing in and got to sort of drown out those voices?
It's really tough. That's a lovely play by 31, Nick, and he's put it up again. It's tough because it's really difficult to keep the momentum and keep the positivity up. You've got to remember what this will lead to later down the line.
And 24 steals there. That mentality is certainly still there. He'll go all the way.
And that's a foul there by number two. So 24 will be shooting on the three-throw line.
And I think he's had a few free throws earlier in the game.
Absolutely. 24, yeah, he likes to drive a lot, so that tends to be the case. Most fouls are when people are putting it up underneath the basket.
Yeah, when these are, you know, few good opportunities to give Bath a few more points. His first will be no good. Let's see if he can make a second. Just practicing his form a little bit there. Put it up quickly and make it.
So that'll be a Plymouth ball from the end line, bringing it back up. They're bringing it up with some speed as well. Bath boys can't catch up. A missed three-pointer there, lands in the backhand. So they'll be taking the ball back down. And a three-point miss there, unfortunately.
Plymouth defence holding strong. It's just less than 4 minutes to go here. 104 to Marjon, 65 Bath. It's been an exciting game. And Bath, I think they've played well despite the scoreline.
Absolutely.
Here comes Marjon again. Try and put one up. Bath nearly winning the rebound. Can't quite get there, but they do eventually get a steal.
Yeah, take back down the other end. A lovely pass out. Nice movement from the Bath boys. And that's unfortunately missed from Tim there, so it goes back up to the
Marjon moving the ball around with style as they put that free up.
By number one.
And that's his fourth of this quarter alone.
He isn't missing. And isn't afraid to shoot either, which is nice.
No, it's good. And I suppose these are the sort of opportunities when you can really sort of hone your shooting and, you know, take those shots that maybe in a bigger game you wouldn't always take.
Yeah, absolutely. They will lose now, but it's so nice to see that they're still giving it a go.
Still giving it a go. That 41-point difference. Well, we never know.
Never say never.
We could see Bath turn it around.
It would be unheard of.
It'd be unheard of. But in the meanwhile, they just got to take this experience, I suppose, and build on it and learn from it.
Yeah, absolutely. Plymouth were always going to be a tough side, so I think they've done pretty well considering.
I suppose just take what you can get, and it's a learning experience every game as you move through the season as well.
Definitely.
Well, it's going to be a Bath or a Plymouth ball here.
So that we've got number 7 shooting there, so
there we go.
A foul on him. Made by the Bath.
They're just taking a while to set up there. Number 7, he's got a free throw opportunity. Let's see if he can make his first.
And he misses. Maybe with help from the bench,
still
making a bit of noise.
See if we can get another.
And he sits that one.
The bench maybe rattled his mentality a little bit, like you said, though.
But he clawed it straight back. That's a lovely steal by number one there. Passes number 7, and that's a foul by 31. He's trying to argue a travel, but unfortunately, mate, that is absolutely a foul. An interesting point of view from up here in the commentator's box.
It's a lot easier to spot the fouls out, even though the lines aren't as clear. Number 13 for Plymouth having a little dance back there. Shows he's comfortable.
Very comfortable
in the position they are in. Smiles all around. And the Bath boys don't look despondent. It's important to say that. They look like, you know, they've still played well.
Absolutely. And we were expecting a loss of this proportion. The Bath boys lost against the M1s last week, so the 2s lost against the 1s by about 40 points, so we're expecting something similar today.
Yeah, exactly. And they still managed to put up 65 points. With just under 3 minutes left, I wouldn't be surprised if they get over 75, something like that, maybe.
Absolutely, it'd be really nice to see that.
Yeah. Well, let's see number 7 if he can get a second free throw after missing his first, and he does. We have a Bath ball here, 24. Puts it into play, 16 collects. Looks for some space, we'll switch it. 14 under pressure.
Drives
from
it in. And a lovely shot there by 14, who's just come on for Bath. And that'll be a Plymouth ball end line.
Number 8, a very physical player. He'll go for the drive. Doesn't quite manage to put up 2 points. He'll collide with his own teammate in what can only be described as a bit of a hug on the court.
Absolutely, and that lands in Bath's hands, and unfortunately, a pass there missed. That'll be back to Plymouth for an end line.
Number 14 with a bit of strapping on his knee there. Is that a bit of injury prevention?
I think a bit of injury prevention. I don't think it's anything too serious. He seems to have played a lot of the game, so this clearly not too bad. But
they call it prehab, don't they? Sort of preventing that injury before it happens. Well, here comes one for Plymouth. Switches it to 7. 7 to 8.
A little
free throw, He's
he lands in Bath's hands, they'll take the ball back up and see if they can get some more points in before the end of the game.
Just 2 minutes left in the game here.
A lovely shot by number 7, but doesn't quite reach. So that'll be a Plymouth ball taking that back down.
Number 7. Just a bit
rebound,
misjudged.
And the Bath team taking it back up.
Barclay
on
the edge.
A 3 point there from Boris, their captain, who doesn't quite make that. That'll be a Plymouth rebound from the back down.
How important is it for the captain to keep the team together here as we have just under 90 seconds left on the clock?
Absolutely. It's really important to keep the positive vibes coming and to keep the mentality straight.
On the drive forward, 13 for the 3-pointer.
And he misses that, and that's a back ball heading back down the court.
It's a quick drive. 16 into the middle, goes for 2.
And unfortunately misses that, and that's a Plymouth rebound there.
More on here, goes for 3 again.
And sinks
it. Well, he's been enjoying his 3-pointers, to say
Absolutely.
The least. Number 1 with his 5th or 6th for the quarter.
And that takes it up to 111 to Marjon, 67 Bath, with a minute left of play.
2 fouls aside, it's been a lot cleaner.
A lot cleaner. I think, you know, with a 40-point difference, it's hard, coming into the last quarter, it's hard to scrap over that. So there's kind of not much point in injuring any of your players. It's not a close game. So that'll be Plymouth ball coming back down the court.
Plymouth go up for the 2.
That's a tough make as well. Very impressive.
And I think it's important, if you've tuned in the second half, that, you know, Bath were right up there in the first.
Absolutely.
They, you know, only sort of ballooned in that third quarter, where suddenly it went from a 1-2-point advantage to 40.
Yeah. Unfortunately so, and that's a nice rebound and a putback by 24, so that's a make there, and he'll be taking one from the line.
There's a foul there as well by Marjon. So 24, he's had plenty of free throw opportunities. He'll have another one here.
Absolutely.
See if he can get it in from that free throw line. The first one is.
And it's a miss, unfortunately, and out by the Plymouth team, so that'll be a Bath ball end line. With an opportunity to get another couple of shots in here with 30 seconds left of play.
Yeah, still plenty, maybe not enough time to get that 40, 50 point.
Yeah, unfortunately, I don't
down.
Think so, but definitely enough to get some more points back on the board. Unfortunately, that's a steal there by Plymouth, so we're taking it back up for another 3 points by number 1, who misses it this time, got put back by number 7 and misses it again. With a foul by 30.
Got a Bath ball with 20 seconds left here. 3 fouls apiece. We had said it had been a clean half there, but in about 10 seconds we've witnessed 2
Absolutely.
Fouls.
Absolutely. We're getting a bit scrappy with it in the last minute of play.
Yeah.
So that'll be number 7 from Plymouth taking 3 throws there.
The Bath boys. Bath boys will be eager to get over 70. The Marjon players will be, I don't know, maybe 115, I suppose, is the target for them.
Well,
maybe 120.
Probably to keep the Bath boys under 70 is probably their aim as well.
Yeah.
And he makes that first one.
Let's see if he can get the second. Number 7 here from the free throw line for Plymouth with 20 seconds remaining on the clock. And that is good.
He's had a little invasion of a dodgeball ball on court there.
Yeah, that is it's a beauty of university sport, is there's always plenty going on.
Absolutely.
You know, you've got BUCS Tier 1 basketball next to a competitive dodgeball match on the other side. Bath have possession
taking
here.
That after another successful 3 throw.
The clock's not actually running at the moment, so the ref has had to stop play. It's been a little bit of a technical error. I'm not sure the boys from Bath will be too fussed.
No, I don't think so.
So, the clock is now running, even though the ball is not in play.
And to send it, you know, put 5 seconds
back
on there.
There we go.
For the 5 seconds of play.
Bit of confusion there, but
there
ball is back in play, and the clock's now.
Clock's not running again, and.
Oh, it's been. I think the boys
are. There we go. They're just going to dribble it out
gonna,
there.
There we go. Well.
And leave that going there.
Fair play to Bath. 69 to Bath. 115 to Marjon, with a 46 point deficit.
Say.
A scoreline that perhaps doesn't reflect the first half performance of the Bath team?
No, I'd agree. You know, we had a really successful first half, and unfortunately it's just slipped away from us in the second half.
Yeah, definitely. And I think it was there's a lot of learning lessons for both sides, I suppose, from that match.
Definitely, definitely. And it'll be really interesting to see how the M2s go on with their games.
If you could choose sort of an MVP from both sides, have you got any players in mind?
Oh, do you know, tough one. I'd say 31 had a really good game today from the Bath side. He had a really good bit of rebounding, a bit of movement. Tim as well. And definitely number three or number one from the Marjon side, I think we'll probably take that.
Well, there we go. It's been an exciting afternoon here at the Founders Hall at the University of Bath. We've seen two great games and two unfortunate results for Bucks basketball teams here, but we'll be sure that they'll be back in action soon with some wins. Thank you very, very much for commentating with me.
Thank you so much, George. Thanks for coming and commentating on game.
No worries. And we hope to see you soon.